Good morning, and once again, welcome to my YouTube channel, Pearson at Excel International Maths by Mr. Kamotho. And we continue to explain Pure Mathematics 1. And we are now in a very, very important topic, topic number 8, differentiation. And at a level which is very critical. It's very important that we understand first principle of differentiation because it will help us in future understanding of pure mathematics moving forward. And in this example, we are told that prove that from the first principle, it's on page 156, prove from the first principles that the derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. And I want to remind you what the first principle means. The first principle from the previous video, we've understood that the gradient is the function of x plus h, where h is a small stretch along the x-axis, minus the function of x all over h. This we have seen in the previous video, but I want to ignore this part and be a bit practical. And the function of y is equals to x cubed will naturally look like this. Because when x is a negative, negative cubed is a bigger negative. When x is a positive, positive cubed is of course a bigger positive. But within that, I want to highlight two points. I want to get an extract of this curve, which is the real curve, and get an extract or a part of that curve and bring it here and call this point A and call this point B. And as far as the curve is concerned, the coordinates of point A is going to be X. Of course, we have to have an X. And the Y coordinates of point A is now the value of y when x is x, and y is always x cubed, so x cubed. And I want to talk about the x coordinates, and before then, I should have talked about a small h now, which is this one. This is a small h from x point A. There is a small increase in length along the x-axis, so that is h. So obviously the x coordinates of point B is x plus h, because we will be talking about this particular point will be x plus h, so x plus h. And the y coordinates of point B is that value of x cubed. Of course, now x plus h cubed. And those are the coordinates of point A and point B. So if we assume we are having a chord AB that way, a chord AB that way, then the gradient of AB is going to be found by the change, the gradient of AB is going to be found by the change in Y, is the change in Y over the change in X, because AB again happens to be a straight line. So what is this change in Y over change in X? The Y coordinates for B is x plus h cubed minus the y coordinates for A minus x cubed all over the x coordinates for B, which is x plus h minus the x coordinates for A, x. And that is that. When you have this, it is important to note that we must be able to expand or open up this. So we are going to have x plus h, three times, which is going to be, probably we can get hold of the first two and have x squared plus xh plus xh plus xh plus 2xh plus h squared. This now multiplies out with the other one, x plus h. And after expanding this, you're going to have x cubed because of this, plus x squared h, and x squared is done with its work, plus 2xh times x, so 2x squared h, that times that, plus 2xh times h, 2xh squared, that times that, plus xh squared, that times that, plus h cubed. We have just opened up this bracket. At this particular point, we need now to collect the like terms, and we have x cubed is just ones, x squared h plus 2x squared h, we are going to have 3x squared h, because that will have to be added to that because they are like terms. Again, xh squared plus another xh squared, 2xh squared plus xh squared is 3xh squared. And of course, h squared is alone. So that is it. And of course, at the denominator, we have x plus h minus x, which is simply a h. But this is just an expansion of this part. So we were to subtract y1, which is minus x cubed. And of course, it goes without saying that x cubed minus x cubed is 0. So we are left with an expression that talks about the gradient is 3x squared h plus 3xh squared plus h cubed all over h. And you realize now that h is a common factor throughout the numerator. So we can get it outside, and we have 3x squared plus 3xh plus h squared all over h. And it goes without saying, of course, we need to clean up this a little bit, and h cancels out, and we are left with a statement that looks like 3x squared plus 3xh plus h squared. Now, at that very point, we need to go back to the diagram. And we have been told that this is the h. As b approaches a, h continues to reduce. We may have b1, our b2 could be there, we may have b3 there, we may have b4 there. As b approaches a, h continues to decrease. And at the very last point, when b gets to very close where a is, h will be 0. And at that point, the line joining A and B will be a tangent of the curve. You have to remember that. So, as h approaches 0, now 3x squared remains 3x squared. The gradient, as h approaches 0, the gradient becomes 3x squared. This term becomes 0 because it has h, and this term becomes 0 because it has h. So the gradient approaches or becomes 3x squared. And therefore, the function of the derivative function becomes 3x squared. So yes, proof. Using the first principle, we have been able to find the derivative of x cubed as 3x squared. Follow all the steps, and I hope you will get home. It's something that you need to be very serious about, and of course, go slowly, and you will get it. Okay?